You are tuned into Daily Top 10, where we bring to you top trending news around the globe. Brought to you by your number one entertainment channel. At number 10, Rotimi and Vanessa Mdee are expecting a second child. Nigerian-American singer and actor Olurotimi Akinyosho, popularly known as Rotimi, and his wife Vanessa Mdee, who is also an artist from Tanzania, have announced that they are expecting their second child after being delivered of their first child on September 28th of 2021. Sharing the good news on his Instagram page, the Nigerian-American actor said, and I quote, "Baby number two, it's a girl." Rotimi and Vanessa became a love affair after meeting at the after party of an Essence Festival in New Orleans and exchanged vows on December 30th, 2020 in Atlanta. At number 9, Anthony Joshua reveals plans to pause on boxing. 33-year-old professional boxer and two-time heavyweight champion Anthony Oluwafemi Olaseni Joshua, who shot to limelight in 2012, having won a gold at the super heavyweight division of the 2012 Olympics and has had an overly successful career, but was stripped off his WBA, IBF and WBO world belts by Ukrainian boxer Oleksandr Usyk in September 2021, has now announced that he will be taking time off professional boxing to take some mental rest and won't be fighting until 2023. Disclosing his last back-to-back defeats by Ukrainian boxer as one that tore him apart, AJ said, and I quote, "It just really tore me apart. So from a mental capacity, my close ones are telling me to rest mentally. Physically, I'm down to ride. I'm a warrior. I like the game and I like competing." Anthony Joshua is undoubtedly one of the biggest names in the British boxing, having dominated the heavyweight division since winning his world titles in a thriller against Vladimir Klitschko in 2007. At number 8, Sunday Igbo honored in the United States of America. Triun Biblical University in the United States of America has honored popular Nigerian activist and philanthropist Chief Sunday Adeni Adeyemo, popularly known as Sunday Igbo, with an honorary doctorate degree. Sharing the news with his Instagram followers, Sunday Igbo said, and I quote, "Congratulations to me as I'm conferred Doctor of Peace and Security Management and International Relations with specialization in war, conflict, and peace studies from Triun Biblical University in the USA. It's such an honor to know that Yoruba Nation's efforts are not in vain." End of quote. The award was presented to the Oduduwa National Agitator by the founder of the university, Reverend Professor Adeleke Durujaye. At number 7, Netherlands order closure of China's police stations in the country. You will recall that in September, we brought to you news on Daily Top 10 that the Chinese government had planted police stations in different nations, having been exposed by Spanish-based non-governmental organization Safeguard Defenders, who after a series of thorough investigations disclosed that China had set up 54 overseas police stations across the globe, with more stations planted in Britain and China. Confirming the news in a recent tweet, the Dutch Foreign Minister, Wokpe Hoekstra, said, and I quote, "Because no permission was sought from the Netherlands for the stations, the ministry informed the Chinese ambassador that the stations must close immediately." End of quote. The two police stations planted in Amsterdam and Rotterdam in 2018 were originally created to offer diplomatic assistance, but have rather been used to silence China's political opponents, broadcaster RTL and investigative websites Living in Netherlands. At number 6, Vector the Viper is set to release new album titled Teslim. Nigerian-born hip-hop artist, music producer, songwriter, and poet Olaiwaju David Ogumefun, popularly known as Vector, has revealed that he will be releasing his most anticipated studio album titled Teslim. In anticipation of the release, the hardcore rapper created a Lafayette podcast radio that questions the sociocultural norm of viewing African history and practices as uncouth. The album, which focuses on several aspects of his life and journey, sees appearances from Good Girl LA, Nasty C, Ladi Po, Shay Vibes, and a host of others.
Respect that cuts across. Okay. Right. So, in that understanding.
But then, you know, we all have different lives, yeah.
Yes,
it's quite essential to know that, see, no matter what, even if you're irrespective of space, you respect souls, you respect territories and stuff and all that, you still have to cut your own coat according to your size, meaning you literally can't be for everybody, even if you think, okay, Danny won't, but bringing value, you can't bring value to everybody.
But so this is what it is. I can actually beg to differ.
How?
See, naturally,
yeah,
wherever I go, the value is not determined by the amount of people that validate it being value or valuable. It's not that. The value is the existence of the value.
At number 5, South Korean footballer Son to undergo eye surgery. Recall that in the first half of Tottenham's recent 2-1 comeback victory against Marseille, in their recent game, South Korean forward Heung-Min Son, who plays for Tottenham Hotspurs and captains national team, picked an injury that took him off the football match and would now see him undergo an eye surgery. In a recent statement issued as an update on the South Korean international, the club said, and I quote, "We can confirm that Heung-Min Son will undergo surgery to stabilize a fracture around his left eye. Following surgery, Son will commence rehabilitation with our medical staff and we shall update supporters further in due time. We don't know yet what his fate is as regards the forthcoming FIFA World Cup, but be sure to get updates right here on Daily Top 10. At number 4, Nigeria Corps members to present fitness certificate at orientation camp. The Director of Press and Public Relations of the National Youth Service Corps, Eddie Megua, has revealed that the latest development to the National Service is that Corps members will, as a matter of necessity, present fitness certificates. This, according to Eddie, is to help the scheme be in the know of its members' health status as well as fish out those who lie about their health condition. Disclosing details of the new development, Eddie said, and I quote, "In view of the regimentation and physical demands of some activities of the NYC orientation program, the management of the scheme introduced presentation of certificates of fitness from recognized public health facilities by prospective Corps members as a requirement for registration at the orientation camp. The new development is expected to take effect in the course of the 2022 Batch C orientation program." Wahala be sitting pretty. At number 3, Dubai uploads Nigeria's digital economic progress. The Dubai World Trade Center, DWCC, at the just-concluded Digital Nigeria Conference and Expo, organized by the NITDA and themed Driving Growth and Unlocking Innovations Through Regulations for a Sustainable Digital Economy, uploaded Nigeria's digital economy progress in the last 3 years. Describing the economic growth as pulsating and encouraging, the DWCC affirmed its commitment to partner with the Nigerian government at all levels to help ensure that Nigerians enjoy a shared benefit of the growing information and communication technology sector in the country. Emphasizing on its will to partner the need for collaboration, the Vice President of the Technology and Digital Cluster of the DWTC, Bilal Arais, said collaboration is the soul of any innovative ecosystem. The DWTC, through the GTEx global platform, has for nearly 50 years fostered and encouraged collaborations for different innovation ecosystems across various countries, as well as helping to provide intranation partnerships. Number 2. AY Comedian bags 12 awards at the Toronto Film Festival. It's an absolute exciting feeling to see that beyond music, the movie industry is also doing well on its part, taking Nigeria to the world. Such kind of excitement comes with the latest win by award-winning comedian Ayo Makun, also known as AY Comedian, who just won 12 awards at the Toronto International Nollywood Film Festival for his movie Almajiri. An excited AY said, and I quote, "My decision to do something different from my comedic comfort zone was only backed with action, and here we are in Canada with 12 awards from 27 nominations to show for it. Achieving this success came as a result of my willingness to use my platform to join a great number of advocates worldwide to call attention to the ongoing issues of different forms of trafficking and forced labor in Nigeria. Almajiri is a true life story that uncovers and highlights in visuals and actions the real life experiences of children in the northern part of Nigeria that are subject to poverty, abuse, forced labor, and so on. The movie stars Segun Arinze, Annie Dibia, Kanayo Kanayo, Rahama Sadao, Adam Baba Ado Zango, and a host of other brilliant actors. At number 1, Tems, Burna Boy, and Fireboy DML feature on Black Panther soundtrack. Black Panther Wakanda Forever, through its official Twitter account, have shared the track list for the sequel soundtrack that would be released on Friday, November 4th, and amazingly, it features some of our favorite persons in the music industry. The 19-track compilation sees appearances from Fireboy DML, Rihanna, Burna Boy, Tobin Wigwe, Snow the Product, E40, Tems, Future, amongst others. Already, Rihanna's Lift Me Up, that serves as a tribute to Chadwick Boseman and was co-written by Tems, is doing well on the charts, having been released a short while ago. Amazing stuff.
Lift me up. Hold me down, keep me close, safe and sound.
And that's it on today's edition of Daily Top 10. For more updates and trending news, kindly follow us on all our social media platforms. Thanks for staying tuned. Bye for now.